Bartchak has been involved in various roles in the church on the state, national, and international level. In 2004, he was appointed to the executive committee of the Pennsylvania Catholic Conference. Bishop Bartchak has also served as a judge for the Congregation for the Doctrine of the Faith at the Vatican. In 2003, he was elected president of the Canon Law Society of America. Bishop Bartchak was ordained and installed as the Bishop of the Diocese of Altoona-Johnstown on April 19, 2011, at the Cathedral of Blessed Sacrament in Altoona. On the basis of working together with Bishop Bartchak in the Diocese of Erie for many years, I can assure you that Bishop Bartchak is one who loves the church, loves his priesthood, and brings to all his endeavors in ministry the heart of a pastor. I'd like to take this opportunity to thank Bishop Brandt for inviting me to give this address on the occasion of this annual Red Mass, sponsored by the Diocese of Greensburg and Saint Vincent Archabbey. In the teachings of the Second Vatican Council and in the explications of the faith by Pope since the Council, it is recommended that the lay faithful who are engaged in the legal and political sectors of our society have a pressing responsibility to bear witness to those human and gospel values that are intimately connected with activities that promote and safeguard the common good. These values include liberty, justice, solidarity, faithful and unselfish dedication for the good of all, a simple lifestyle, and a preferential option for the poor and those on the margin of society. This demands that the lay faithful be more animated by a real participation in the life of the and enlightened by the Church's social teaching, which is illuminated by the theological virtues of love, hope, and faith. Your presence here for the annual Red Mass is a strong indication that your minds and your hearts are enlightened by the love of faith. Pope Francis reminds us in his encyclical letter, Lumen Fidei, that faith teaches us to see that every man and woman represents a blessing for me, that the light of God's face shines on me through the faces of my brothers and sisters. To see the world and to see every other human person that way is to see our world and to understand the common good with the vision of Christ Jesus. Anything less or anything different will result in the temptation to see the world with the cynical and destructive vision of those who find it easy to devalue, to dismiss, or even to destroy another human person because he or she is simply no good to me. And should any one of us ever give in to that temptation, remember the encouragement that Pope Francis holds out in the final pages of his encyclical. He says, faith offers the possibility of forgiveness, which so often demands time and effort, patience and commitment. Forgiveness is possible once we discover the goodness, that goodness is always prior to and more powerful than evil, and that the word with which God affirms our life is deeper than our very denial of that word. We may at times try to deny the truth, but we cannot redefine what has been established by God. Thanks be to God for the truth that is illuminated by the light of faith, the truth that reminds us that every individual has a fundamental goodness that is God-given, the truth that reminds us that